Hi everyone, it's Gus from Pi My Life Up, and today I'll be going through how to make a simple battery tester using the Arduino. This is a great nifty tool that allows you to roughly check how much charge is left in a battery. This is a pretty bare bones project, but it could be extended to be a proper little battery testing kit. I will quickly mention the equipment that you'll need for this project. An Arduino Uno, one 2.2k ohm resistor, three 100 ohm resistors, one 5.1 volt Zener diode, a green, red and yellow LED, breadboard wire, and of course a breadboard. This circuit is pretty easy to put together. If you have been following my tutorials, then you will notice we're using a new component in this one called the Zener diode. The Zener diode will allow you to test batteries that have a voltage greater than 8 volts. A Zener diode works by allowing current to flow in one direction until it hits the breakdown voltage. This is the limit on the diode. Once it hits this limit, it allows voltage to flow in the opposite direction. This can help protect parts that can only handle a certain amount of voltage, in our case the Arduino. The 2.2k ohm resistor reduces the current coming from a battery to something that the Arduino will be able to take in. If your current is too high, then it may damage the Arduino. The three LEDs we'll be using represents roughly how much charge there is left in the battery. Red will represent when the battery is almost dead, yellow will represent the battery being roughly half used, and finally the green will represent the battery being full. So let's get building our circuit. First, wire the ground pin from the Arduino to the ground rail on the breadboard. On the breadboard, place a red, green and yellow LEDs. If you're unsure which pin is the negative one, it is the shorter one or the one with a larger flag. The larger flag can be seen if you look into the LED. Connect the ground pins on the LED to the ground rail on the breadboard. Place a 100 ohm resistor onto each of the positive ends of the LEDs, then hook a wire from the resistor to the pins on the Arduino. The LEDs should connect to the relevant pin on the Arduino. Red should go to pin 4, yellow should go to pin 3, and green should go to pin 2. Now connect up the analog pin 0, A0, to the breadboard, add a 2.2k resistor and the Zener diode, with a line on the Zener diode facing in the direction of the Arduino. Finally, have a loose wire coming from the other end of the diode, and lastly have a loose wire connected to the ground rail. The code for this project is pretty straightforward, but I will explain each section so you can understand what we're doing if you're not familiar with coding. Firstly, we need to set up all our variables. The LED variables are all assigned to their relevant pin number on the Arduino. The analog value variable is where we'll be storing the value that comes from a battery input. The voltage variable is where we will store the calculated voltage value from the analog value variable. Finally, LED delay is how long we want our LEDs to remain on before switching them off. This is in milliseconds. The setup function is called once and is the perfect place to set up all our pins. In this particular program, we need to set up all our LED pins to be outputs. Inside the loop function, we will need to do a couple of things. Firstly, we read the analog pin. The value from this pin will be between 0 and 1023. We will need to do a calculation to convert this to a voltage, so we simply multiply the analog value by 0.0048 to do this. This last part, we compare our calculated voltage to our defined voltage values for what's good, okay, and a bad battery. Once you are done either writing the code up or downloading it, and you have done the circuit, simply deploy it to the Arduino. Now you will notice it keeps randomly changing between the LEDs. This is because the wire is floating and the Arduino is picking up a lot of noise. To stop this, you can simply ground the positive wire when it's not in use. You can also try grounding the other analog pins to help reduce noise. To test it, all you need to do is hook up a battery to the two wires. Place the ground wire to the negative end of the battery and the positive wire to the positive end of the battery. The Arduino should pick up the voltage and tell the relevant LED to light up. First, I'm going to test a dead battery, and as you can see, it comes up as red. Now we'll test a fully charged battery, and Again, you can see it come up as green. Finally, I will test a battery that is at about half charge, and as you can see, it comes out to be yellow. If it doesn't look like it's working or you're having trouble, then simply try adding some debug lines for the battery input. This should tell you if there's something wrong with reading the input or if there's a mistake for displaying the LEDs. Now this tutorial just covers the very basics of this project. You could extend it to be a lot better and to be more of a permanent device that you'll use day to day. For example, you could print out the output to an LCD screen connected to the Arduino. This could give you a lot more accurate information. I will be going into how to set up an LCD screen with the Arduino in the very near future. You could also add a proper battery holder instead of using the two wires to check the life of a battery. This will make it a bit safer and make it look very professional. I hope you have been able to build this basic but cool Arduino battery tester. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.